Not only are we gathering together in the cold dead of winter, we are also in the heart of the flu season. It started some weeks before Christmas. I read on the internet yesterday they expect he will still get worse and we'll be facing it for the next 4, 5, or 6 weeks more. So it's a little scary. A flu can afflict very tiny children, sometimes seriously, and folks my age and up can be hurt pretty badly, but we're not terrified of disease in this era the way folks were in the past. Imagine yourself at the time of Jesus. Even the most educated people did not understand that there were germs. They didn't understand about sanitation. They didn't know how disease was spread from one person to another. They pretty much had to simply endure it. And people died pretty steadily. In those days, if you asked somebody how they were doing, the question really meant something. They wondered if you'd be around that afternoon. Death and illness was such a constant factor in people's lives. I think, however, some diseases were more terrifying than others, and leprosy was certainly one of those. Now, it's still relatively early in the morning. I don't know if you just got your bacon and eggs down or post-toasties, but I don't want to give all the details of leprosy. But leprosy, basically, is the human body rotting away while you're still alive. Fingers and toes fall off. Eventually, of course, the body decays entirely. It smells. It's scary. And no one had any idea how it started and no way to cure it. Today, leprosy is quite curable. In those days, there was no cure. So the leper basically left his family, left his nearest and dearest, stopped his work, had to wear special clothes, and if he was going down a country road, he had to cry out, "Unclean! Unclean!" so that people without leprosy would avoid his company. Today's gospel tells the story of someone who had leprosy, but he heard that Jesus was in the neighborhood. He no doubt had heard that Jesus preached a word of comfort to those in need, and he even heard that Jesus could work miracles. The exchange between Jesus and the leper is translated in different ways, but it basically is the leper came up to Jesus and said, "If you want to, you can make me clean." And Jesus answers with such wonderful reassurance. He basically says, "Of course I want to." Then he touched the leper, which was against the ritual law, and he said, "Be made clean." Because he didn't want to be a kind of sideshow, so miracle worker. He said, "Don't tell anybody about this." But the leper announced the good news to everybody he met, that he had met Jesus Christ, the Lord had touched him, and he was now clean, saved, cured of his leprosy. I think this is a pretty great gospel for a scouting mass. You know, in scouting, you learn things a lot more important than how to camp out or how to tie knots or all the different things which rightly you earn badges for. Most of all in scouting is you learn how to be givers. You learn how to help one another. You learn to meet needs when you encounter them. So the heart of scouting is to really be like Jesus. When you are there to help, you say something like, "Of course I'll help." When somebody reaches out to you, you readily answer, "I'm there for you." So the heart of scouting, I think, is very close to the heart of the Christian gospel, where we forgive, where we help, where we go the extra mile and then make God's reign manifest, present on the earth. But there's another part of that gospel that I think is important for all of us, and that is that leper and Jesus touched each other. The Lord reached out and touched the leper. You know, in a couple minutes, really, we'll be coming to Holy Communion. We have already heard God's word in the Bible, that word that teaches what is right, that word that guides us all our lives, that living word we need. But our worship doesn't end there. We gather around the table of the Lord, God's holy altar, and we actually receive the risen Christ into our hearts and souls. There is a touching that goes on there where Jesus touches us that's even more miraculous than in touching the leper and curing him. So we come to Holy Communion this morning. Let's imitate the faith of that leper. Let us bring to the Lord our needs. Let us bring to him what scares us. Let us bring to him what we're happy about. Let us not be afraid to bring our brokenness to the Lord. And know the risen Christ will touch our hearts and lives. We will physically be in contact with us, and we have the beginning of a heaven that knows no end. We already catch sight of God. We already see in a limited way, but a true way, God face to face. And although the Lord told that leper, don't be talking about this everywhere. He didn't want to be a sideshow. Your bishop is telling you, when you meet Christ, tell it everywhere. Tell everyone you meet by what you say and mostly what you do, that Jesus is your Savior. He is your teacher. He is your Lord. He is your God.